Hi everyone, this is Fran from Travis. I've been caught shoplifting. I'm going to get charges pressed against me. Before the police come, I need to share with you all this stuff that I've nicked. First of which is this record, The Travelling Wilburys.
Why is it all the good ones are on the top shelf?
So I remember, like, I knew who Bob Dylan was, I knew the name. George Harrison I knew. I loved Roy Orbison. In fact, Roy Orbison was the reason I picked up a guitar, because I saw him on TV when I was about 12, and I asked my mum to buy me a, instead of getting a present for Christmas, get me a guitar instead. But this album is it's like a doorway, it's like a gateway into another time in music. Speaking of the Beatles, I never knew this record existed. STAX Does the Beatles. Things like Day Tripper by Otis Redding. Otis Redding is just amazing. Booker T and the MGs singing Eleanor Rigby. As long as they can give me a record player in my cell, I'll be happy. James Taylor. I guess this is a live album by James Taylor. He's a fellow baldy. I'm sort of headed there myself.
Now the 1st of December, covered with snow.
Ah, Creedence Clearwater Revival. Double album. The thing about double albums is they're heavy. Vinyl is just such a tactile medium. It's not like CDs or, I mean, there's nothing now. There's no, it's invisible now. Music just exists, but this is proper. And this guy had one of the best voices in rock and roll. And they made it seem effortless. And there's a great picture in the middle that makes you want to join a rock and roll band. Oh! When I was about 5 years old, my granda had a radiogram. It's like a sideboard. It had a radio in it and a record player and a slot for records. I remember hearing Otis Redding for the first time when I was around about 5 or 6, so I just put this record on and tried to sort of figure out how it worked. And when I saw this today, it took me right back, because it kind of looks the same. The artwork's kind of similar. And this guy was, I mean, wow. And he died, like, so young. Terrible. Yes, everybody know they call me Mr. Pitiful. Most every place I go. Okay. This album is an essential.
Big stunner. Speaking of Memphis, my friend's father is the guy who took this photograph. William Eggleston, who's the greatest living American photographer.
There's a really good documentary about Big Star. It gives you an idea of how close they came, but they never made it. And yet they are one of the greatest songwriting rock and roll bands that ever existed. And I only know about them because of Teenage Fan Club, who are from Glasgow. I've got one left. Oh yeah, R.E.M's Out of Time. I've got lots of memories, but this soundtracked my summer when it came out. And every time I hear Shiny Happy People, it takes me back to Glasgow, where the sun doesn't usually shine, but we had a really sunny summer, and so this was forever connected with happy sunny days. And I'll cherish it when I'm in prison for stealing all this vinyl. I'm quite happy to go down for it. And this is Fran Healy signing off.